kind of
thinking
think
about
so.
What actually happened to him.
I don't think this is just fantasy. It just felt too real.
Oh, man.
It sucked me in. All right, today we're checking out Dan Fogelberg. We're listening to the song Same Old Lang Syne. Let's get into it.
Where am I missing? I thought he said he met her in the grocery store. And I
right.
was like, oh, it's a sweet love song.
And now we find out she's married to an architect who she doesn't exactly like. Maybe she's just kind of bored in her relationship. I don't know. Somehow this architect is not meeting her needs.
Wait, so she's with the architect and him at the same time?
Well, she just met this guy and it sounds like they're going to hook up.
I thought he was saying like 20 years later, this is where her life went, this is where my life went.
Oh, so this is not like she's about to cheat?
Oh, man, I don't know.
Yeah, I was really getting distracted by those snow-covered trees in the background at the beginning of the song.
They look nice.
No, I was trying to see how long it takes before it repeats. Oh. I thought, I wonder how that was to make. You know, I identified a cluster of trees to see. Anywho, I got distracted.
Oh.
So, but I think she's about to cheat.
Okay.
But she didn't like to lie. I said the years had been a friend to her, and that her eyes were still as blue. I'm sure if I saw doubt or gratitude, she said she saw me in the record store, and that I must be doing well. I said the audience was heavenly, but the traveling was hell. We drank a toast to innocence. To reach beyond the emptiness, but neither felt that old familiar pain. And as I turned to make my way back home, the snow turned into
that dirty sax at the end. That was the tune of the original Auld Lang Syne song.
Oh. Do you know what the original is about?
No. But I know it's like a New Year's song, and it's like supposed to be like, say goodbye to the old year, welcome the new. Like, it's okay. That kind of vibe. But how does it tie into this? Because he said, like, the years have been good to her. So I'm like, okay, so they definitely parted ways at some point.
So they knew each other back in the day.
They must
maybe have. In high school. Because for a minute, it took me back to high school.
It must be, like, his high school love or something. Then all these years later, he sees her and they have a drink. But it's...
Catch up.
They catch up.
Finds out she's married.
Yeah.
Still, you know, they kissed.
Why'd the snow turn into rain?
Because everyone loves snow. It's so beautiful. It coats the earth. Oh, it's snowing. Look at that. Da-da-da-da.
Okay.
Nobody likes being rained on. Like, he was out and about and then it started raining. But I mean, it didn't literally start raining. That's how he felt when they parted ways.
Dang. You know what I mean? So it's like reality hit him.
Like, yeah, like seeing her is like being in the snow. Everyone loves snow. And then when she leaves, it's like, and then that's when you got the saxophone coming in to bring in that sadness of them parting. They may part forever. I mean, I don't know when the song was written. They probably just didn't have cell phones. Like, oh yeah, text me, you know. That'd be a sneaky link.
Right. Dang. Oh, man. So he got to feel young and carefree for a moment.
Yeah.
And then it snapped him back into reality.
Yeah. And even if they don't part forever, he might feel dirty if you're trying to get with a married woman.
Right. And even, like, I don't know. It's complicated.
Yeah, but musically, I thought he did a fantastic job of, like, encapsulating the emotions he was going through. Like, even on the part where he talks about the kiss, his voice got higher and the music turned up a little bit.
Yeah.
Like, you tell he got, like, excited, he's having a kiss. But then the whole time, the music to me was like, he was just melted. Like, so infatuated with this woman. It just totally melted him. He was, like, at her mercy.
Yeah, whoa. That was interesting. I wonder if this actually happened to him. You know?
I kind of
think
so.
Singing about what actually happened to him.
I don't think this is just fantasy. It just felt too real.
Oh, man.
It sucked me in.
Oh, man.
I don't know. Tell me, man, what do you know? What do you know? Me and my boys on the road. You the go. She told me, boy, you the go. Like, I don't know. But I don't know.